2:8-11. Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord." While we read this, I'm just thinking about this as a story of Christmas, and something we read over and over for this whole month, and year to year. And this time around, the word "behold" stood out to both of us, actually. And so we looked it up, and the word "behold" means to grasp, to take hold of, to attain, to appreciate. And then the antonym, the only antonym that I had in the dictionary for it was to miss. To miss out. And just seeing it in the scripture, seeing it written to us, from the beginning it says, like, "And behold," it says, "And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them," and it's saying, like, "Listen up, listen to what you're reading right here. Like, get this, you need to understand this. This is what happened on this night." And then the angel saved the people, saved the shepherds, "Do not be afraid, behold, a Savior is born." And just knowing up until this moment, like, here it is, the moment that all of creation and all of the world are waiting for. Salvation is here. A Savior has come. He's here. Behold, don't miss it. Don't miss out. And knowing that on that night and on that day, people missed it. And, like, today, it's still the same thing. Like, behold, pay attention. Like, you're going to miss it. The Lord is here. The Savior is here. Don't miss it today. And people are going to miss it today. And I guess just, like, in this Christmas story, right here in front of us, like, it's don't miss out. Like, don't miss out. Get this now. Take it. Get a handle on it. Like, this is, it's right here before you. And, like, I know, like, in my own life, this past couple weeks, like, I've been working as a substitute teacher. And, like, one of the things that I have a hard time seeing is that, like, oftentimes, like, I lose sight that Jesus is here in this moment. Like, not only the Savior's here for salvation, like, he's in our every day, every moment. Like, and so often I lose sight of that. And I've been selling these past couple of weeks, and last week I was working at an elementary school. And, you know, we start our morning way before school starts. And I screwed up that morning, and I called Alyssa on the phone, and just to repent and try to talk to her. And, like, so easily right there before the school bell even rang, like, I was already taken out, I wanted to bury my head in the sand, like, screwed up, and, you know, it was as if Jesus wasn't alive. And as the kindergarten started coming in, like, I had, like, right at that moment to live and walk in his grace. Like, I had that opportunity where I could bury my head in the sand, or behold, like, here he is. And, I did. That was not something that I could miss. You know? I need help. I need help in that moment. I need to this one with him. So.
And I think off of that, one of the things that God's been doing in my life just through this month of prayer and beginning this month of prayer of repentance and asking God to make a change in my life. And as the month progressed, really just seeing even more how much I'm not constantly in prayer. And you know, those mistakes, those times where, you know, my anxiety caused me to worry and do something stupid, or my insecurity made me have anger and then say something rude, or, you know, act not in accordance with God's will. And God pointing out to me that that's a breach of prayer. Like, that anytime I sin, really, I'm walking out of step of that relationship that I have with Christ. I'm choosing to say, "No thanks, I don't want to listen to you right now. I don't want to take this moment and grasp hold of it fully for what it is. I want to do my own thing." And I miss out on what God wants to do right then and there in that moment. think I want or what I need or my opinion or my feeling. And so I choose to do my own thing instead of grasping and taking a hold of Christ. And so coming out of this month of prayer, being glad that God did that in my life and showed me, you know, those areas and what it means to walk past the God in prayer. And to take those moments when I feel myself going down the wrong path and get reconnected with God, get reconnected with my purpose here, my mission, and what God's called me to, and to keep that communication with God constant, and with that, to not miss out on the opportunity that God has for me, whether it be the big, you know, picture of whatever it may be, or the small, everyday decision that comes in this very moment. And I think really just this Christmas season and enjoying amidst all the chaos and confusion and, you know, just watching, you know, cars zoom by on Christmas Eve and people going here, there, and everywhere, and feeling that chaos in me a little bit, but being able to say, you know what, Christ is here and I'm going to enjoy Him.
Thank you.